Hey everyone, Toby and Mamas Row here, and I'm here to talk about My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. I love this show to death. I love the characters, I love the plots, I love pretty much everything to do with it. However, there is one little problem, and that's the lack of continuity. You see, there are a couple of times where the episodes just don't click together. For example, the episode Sweet and Elite occurs after the Grand Galloping Gala, yet Twilight says it's coming up. That doesn't make any sense. So, I think I'm going to try and place all the episodes from seasons 1 and 2 together in the chronological order. But to make things easier, I'm going to put them in order from when they were first broadcast. So here we go. First off, you got the Friendship is Magic two-parter. This is, what a lot of people would say to be the first episode. I've said a lot of people because, well, you'll see what I mean later. But anyways, this is obviously when Twilight and Spike first come to Ponyville. So every episode that features at least one of them must broadcast after this two-parter special. Next up, you got the Ticketmaster. This episode features in the summer, quite obviously, because Twilight states later on in the episode, it's summer. So, this would probably feature later on in the summer, because, well, Twilight seems to know the other five pretty well at this point. So, that's what I'm going to do. Then you got Applebuck season. This most likely takes place during the fall, because Applejack is harvesting some apples at this point. And he wouldn't really do that in any other season if it's a huge harvest. Maybe a couple of apples here and there, but not a great big harvest. So I'm going to put this in the fall. Griffin the Brush Off is fairly early in the timeline, because Pinkie Pie and Rainbow Dash don't appear to know each other that well. Rainbow Dash talks about her new friends, and Twilight's busy reading a book to pay much attention to Pinkie Pie at the beginning of the episode. So that indicates to me she doesn't know the other five that well yet. In Ghostbusters, this is a pretty early episode as well, because the other five don't seem to know Twilight that well yet, and Twilight's a bit shy to show her magic skills in front of Trixie. So I'd say this is pretty darn early in the timeline. Oh, Fluttershy! Oh, sorry. the episode Dragonshy. Fluttershy is a bit more assertive than she is in previous episodes, so this would be a little bit later than some of the other ones. Oh, little Fluttershy is cute. Cuteness overload. Anyway, this is definitely later in the timeline. By contrast, in Look Before You Sleep, the six main don't seem to know each other that well yet. So I'd put this earlier on in the timeline. Plus the fact that, Applejack and Rarity have a huge argument in this episode, so that indicates to me that they don't know each other too well. So definitely early in the timeline, like I said before. Bridal Gossip is another one that's early in the timeline, because Twilight and Spike don't know anything about Sakura. So this definitely... Oh yeah, and the CMC have not yet formed, and we've never seen Sakura before. So this is pretty early in the timeline. Swarm of the Century could be the last episode for a while, but it's definitely after Bridal Gossip, because we see Sakura in this one. But it's also after Suited for Success, which is later on in the broadcasting. So this one is the last episode for the summer, I think. So let's do that. Oh, Fluttershy, I so cute with the bunny. Oh, sorry. In the episode Winter Wrap-Up, this one obviously takes place at the end of the winter. So that's pretty easy. Call of the Cutie seems to take place in early fall, because Apple Bloom just started school and doesn't seem to know any pony very well yet, until near the end where she meets Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo. Oh, the CMC are so cute! Sorry, cuteness overload again. Oh dear, I think Sweetie Belle's the cutest of the CMC. In the episode 4 with the friends, this one quite obviously takes place at the end of the fall. By the way, Pinkie Pie and Spike's commentary? Hilarious! The episode suited for its success must take place after the Ticketmaster, because this is when they start to prepare to go to the gala. But it must take place before Storm of the Century, because we see Rarity's gala dresses in them. That's another goof in the TV series out of order. So, yeah. By the way, the dresses on the ponies look great. In the episode Feeling Pinky Keen, we see that Twilight's not that used to Pinkie Pie because she doesn't know about her pinky senses or her pet alligator Gummy. By the way, pinky senses are very useful. I even put them into my series for Pinkie Pie. So, yeah, random fact. The episode Sonic Rainboom could most likely take place after Look Before You Sleep. As Applejack and Rarity are still at Twilight's house, Pinkie Pie could have just come to visit, and Spike's absent. So, he could still be in Canterlot, as we are told in Look Before You Sleep that Spike is in Canterlot on royal business. Sweetie Belle, so cute. Oh, sorry. In the episode Stairmaster, the CMC are obviously in the earlier stages of trying to get their cutie marks, so this can't be too long after Call of the Cutie. Oh, look at the CMC, they're so cute. Oh, sorry. By contrast, in the Showstoppers, the CMC clearly know lots more about each other and each other's special talents, but they don't know their own special talents yet. So I'm going to put this a while after Stairmaster. Also, since summertime in America is a good time to hold a school talent show, I'm going to put it there. In a Dog and Pony Show, we see that Rarity's an extremely well-known designer, so I'm going to put this after Suited for Success. By contrast, in Green Isn't Your Colour, Rarity isn't very well known, so this must be before Suited for Success. Not to mention that Spike has his obsessive crush on Rarity in both episodes, so they're pretty early off in the timeline, due to the fact that when Spike got to know Rarity better, he probably wasn't so obsessed over her. In Over a Barrel, this takes place pretty darn close to the apple harvest, putting it pretty close to Applebuck season. By the way, the I'd like to be a tree scene, loved it. Fluttershy was just adorable in that scene, and she's adorable in this picture now with Twilight. Oh boy. Oh, goodness me. No wonder she's cutest pony. Another cute Fluttershy scene. Oh, sorry. In A Bird in the Hoof, this is clearly after Suited for Success because we see Rarity's gala dress in it. If you haven't already guessed, Fluttershy is my favourite pony. Aww, he's cute. Oh, that's adorable. A group hug. Oh, oh, whoops. Cuteness overload again. This is... In the Cutie Mark Chronicles, we see that the CMC are kind of independent in this one. They try ziplining on their own, but they ask the main six for help on how to get their cutie marks. So... I put this a little bit after Stairmaster, but not too much. Owl's All That Ends Well could go anywhere at this stage, because Owlicious hasn't been seen in any of the other episodes besides this one and made the best pet win. So, I'm taking a random guess that this happens in the fall. Party of One? Likely an early episode, because Pinkie Pie does not fully trust her friends as of yet. This is also shows Spike's obsessive crush on Rarity, because he doesn't know her that well. when he gets to know her better, he probably wasn't as obsessed over her. But if Twilight knows Gummy, this must be after filling Pinky Keen. Best night ever? It must be a while after Ticketmaster and Suited for Success, because this is the kind of event you'd have a lot of time to prepare for. Now on to season 2. This could be a bit of argued against because Rarity's and Twilight's horns are different colours in this season, as well as other ponies riding to the princess. I'm going to ignore both these facts and assume that Rarity and Twilight like to change their horns' colours from time to time, and the letters you hear at the end of the episode aren't necessarily written at the same time the episode aired, or at the same episode occurred, I meant to say. So anyways, on to season 2. The Return of Harmony two-parter can't be too long after Stairmaster, because the CMC don't know each other that well, but it must take place after Winter Wrap-Up because there's a flashback of that episode later on. Also, since this is a two-part special, you wouldn't really put this close to a Canterlot wedding because it wouldn't really make sense that there are two-parters at the same time. Lesson 0 seems to be a later episode because Twilight knows the other five pretty well by now, and vice versa. The other five are also upset of the idea of Twilight being taken away, and they seem to be fairly well acquainted with the princess. Lunar Eclipse? It seems to have a holiday that is based around Halloween, so we can assume that it happens around the same time of year. By the way, Pipsqueak, Cutest Cult, and definitely goes well with Sweetie Belle. In the episode Sisterhood Social, Sweetie Belle... this episode would occur after Call of the Cutie, because Sweetie Belle knows Apple Bloom by this point. Also, it wouldn't occur too long after it, because Sweetie Belle doesn't really know how to live with Rarity that well yet. So I'd put it not too long after Call of the Cutie. By the way, where was Scootaloo? She should have totally been in this episode and she and Rainbow Dash should have competed. The Cutie Pox? Probably takes place a while after Stairmaster, as the Cutie Mark Crusaders have been trying for a while to get their cutie marks. Also, just look at that picture. The CMC is so cute. Oh, look at Fluttershy. So adorable. Sorry. In May the Best Pet Win, this is obviously after Owl's Well That Ends Well, because that is where we're introduced to Owlicious, and that is when Twilight adopts Owlicious as her pet. So, yeah. By the way, the Rainbow Dash Fluttershy duet, loved it to bits. The Mysterious Mare duel is obviously after the Showstoppers because we see the CMC's clubhouse. This episode wasn't as bad as a lot of people say it is. My favourite part was the fan club. And right on this episode is where I thought to myself, what we really need is a Scootaloo episode. In the episode Sweet and Elite, we see that Rarity's career as a designer has gotten very popular. Not only that, but we see Rarity's gala dress in this episode, so it must be after Suited for Success. It also must be before Best Night Ever, because Twilight stated that the gala was coming up. So, this would have to be between those two episodes. In the episode Secret of My Excess, this would have to be the last one for a while, because Ponyville's been completely destroyed at the end. Not only that, but it must be less than a year after Twilight and Spike came to Ponyville, because Spike stated that it was his first birthday in Ponyville. In Heartwarming Eve, this is a Christmas-based holiday, so we can assume that this episode could take place around the same time. I've never seen a Family Appreciation Day, so I'm gonna take a guess from what other people have I've heard from. We see the CMC's clubhouse, so this must be after the Showstoppers, and Apple Bloom and the other CMC go to school, from what I've seen from a couple of pictures. So this episode might take place around the fall. Baby Cakes is a later episode because we've never seen the Cake Twins before. And might I add, they're so adorable. Oh, sorry, cuteness overload again. The last roundup could take place a while after Swarm of the Century, as they're still rebuilding Ponyville in it. Also, Fluttershy, Applejack, and Twilight's hug right there is so cute. Oh my goodness me. The ending is so well put together in this episode, it just makes me want to cry. Oh, sorry. By the way, worst part of the episode is Derpy. I'm getting a lot of hate for that, but, you know, haters got to hate. The Super Saiyan Squeezy 6000, or however that title said, is probably a little bit before Applebuck season, because the apples still have apple trees, as seen in this picture. Also, this could be before a Dog and Pony show, because Spike says it's nearly Sapphire season, and that's probably what we see in a Dog and Pony show when he's hunting for gems of rarity. Readers and Weep is probably a later episode, as we've never seen Rainbow Dash reading in previous episodes. Hearts and Hoofs Day is a holiday that's similar to Valentine's Day, so we can assume it takes place around the same time. And by the way, the CMC looks so cute when they're hopping like that, especially Sweetie Belle. Oh, so cute. Like the episode Family Appreciation Day, I hadn't seen A Friend Indeed, but I have seen the Smile song. Anyways, from what I heard from others, we see the Cake Twins and Rainbow Dash reading Daring Do in it, so that takes place after both those episodes. By the way, the Smile song is so damn catchy. This episode is probably what makes everything differ from your timelines. I actually consider this episode the first one, from what I've heard from others. Fluttershy learning assertiveness, and she was assertive in Dragonshy, Best Night Ever, and a lot of other episodes. So, I think this might be the first one. Twilight and Spike are not mentioned either, or seen. Rainbow Dash isn't reading Daring Do, let alone she's not in the episode whatsoever. So, I actually think this could be an event before Twilight and Spike come to Ponyville. It's about time? Has Twilight behaving similar to how she did in Lesson Zero? By the way, had not seen this one or Putting Your Hoofs Down either. But from what I've heard from others, this could be around the same time as Lesson Zero. Dragon Quest. This episode could occur during the fall, because the dragons are migrating. And it must occur after Secret of My Excess, because we see the blanket that Applejack gave Spike in that episode. Hurricane Fluttershy? This could take place during the early spring, because they're sending fresh water up to Cloud Sail, which would occur during the rainy season, I guess you could say. By the way, this is definitely one of the best episodes during Season 2. And that hug between Rainbow Dash and Fluttershy is so adorable. Aww. In Ponyville Confidential, it seems like the CMC have just started school again. So I'd put this around the early fall. By the way, that hug between Fluttershy and the CMC is so cute. Oh, she forgives them. Oh. In this episode, Mystery on the Friendship Express, we see that this is a baking competition, which is something that would usually take place in spring or the early summer. Bear in mind that this aired on the Easter weekend, so we can assume that it happened around the same time. The A Candlelit Wedding two-parter most likely happens in the spring, because that's when the real royal wedding occurred. Not to mention that Rarity's a better known designer in this two-parter, and that the other five are better familiar with Celestia. By the way, this is definitely by far the best episode of season 2. Full timeline. Music, please! we have it, guys. All 52 episodes of seasons 1 and 2 placed into chronological order. Now, I left season 3 out because it's not complete yet. When it's complete, I'll do that one as well. I may need some help putting those episodes in order. Also, if you think an episode is out of order in my timeline already, feel free to tell me in the comments below. Also, what's your favorite episode of seasons 1 and 2? And right now, season 3, from what's already been done. See you around, everypony.